I'm hot, sizzling. Don't count me out. Nah. It all begins
right here,
right now. Catch me if you can. Never really care what they say.
On God,
only ever care about one thing.
Ching, ching, ching.
Cha-chain, cha-chain, rackets, rackets.
Hit the bank.
Ba-bang, ba-bang, put you in your place. Wait, they done got me started. Without me, it's not a party.
Nope.
Mar, he got it rocking. We bring havoc to your lobby. Tristan, he got shoddy. They gon' copy cause we poppin'. My wallet. If I like it, then I cop it.
Hold up, check me out.
Hold up.
I think the tables and turn.
Forget the bridge we done built. This time I let them all burn.
They tried to count me out.
Well, now it's the word.
I
bring it paper, paper, paper from the first to the first.
They count me out.
Yeah.
Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling.
Don't
count me out.
Nah.
It all begins
right here.
Right now. Catch me if you can.
As the Titans get set to match up with the Denver Broncos. The first quarter of the season already in the rearview mirror, and off we go in week 5 on EA Sports. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Henry, and he'll power ahead, but only for about 3 yards. Second down coming up.
Well, from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. But let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. 3 3-yard gains, that means they're punting the ball likely on fourth down. That's what you're looking for when you're playing defense.
A quick throw here out to Brown. And he's got this almost to the 40 before going out. With these run pass options, we often talk about a good quarterback and running back. Well, having a talented wide receiver helps also.
Yeah, even coming in third in the discussion, sometimes that means he really should be first, because all you want to do is get the ball in their hands and let them make the big plays downfield.
A first down carry for Henry. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us, need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give them the yardage that they needed, but they really want him to be that guy, and that's what they're doing early in this game.
Second down, they go again with Henry. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Now they're going to be dealing with a 3rd and 7. Is that one officially a loss of one?
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game. So what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
He finds his target. It's Schultz. And he gets this only to the 44-yard line. Not near enough to keep the drive alive. A bad time for a roughing penalty. And they get the gift of a 1st and 10. Back to throw here. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Pat Surtain. And the Broncos are going to get the football here as they force the INT on the game's opening drive. Well, that is a quick lesson on how difficult this defense is to throw against, an interception on their initial drive of the ball game.
Now we know why their offensive staff spent the entire week awake trying to prepare for this one, because you can't totally shy away from throwing the football, but at the same time you're looking at them and going, where are the weaknesses? How are we going to move it?
One of the top defenses in the NFL for a reason. We just saw one example right there. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
Now a 2nd down and 6. And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. This defense for the Titans, they were very good last week in the win over New Orleans.
And I'm eager to see the game plan and trying to attack them this week, because when you take it away 4 times through interceptions, what do you do now when you go into a game? Do you decide you can't throw the ball? Do you try and run it more? Or do you tell your quarterback, make sure you see your guys open before you deliver?
Looking to throw. A bullet throw, but incomplete. So it doesn't look like they're going to be able to build off the turnover.
Well, the defense certainly did its part. It got them the football. But you're exactly right. It looks like they're going to have to punt this one away. And it's not a turnover, but doesn't it feel like one after grabbing the momentum with the defensive play?
Yeah, and they had all that momentum after getting the football, and now zapped right back in the other direction. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. Now, they were intercepted the first time they had the football, but now they get it back, and it's still 0-0.
And because of that, you know what the thought process is? Interception.
In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. Baron Browning, he brought the pressure on the blitz, and he gets there for a loss of 12. A lot of ground to cover. 2nd and 22. A shotgun handoff to Henry. And he'll take this one up to about the 13. Give him 5 yards on the run there, but it'll leave him with a definite 3rd and long on the horizon. They'll look to throw. This is caught. It's Brown. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up the first down.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. Second and nine now. Quick slant to Brown.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
And they will get to this one and down it at the 13-yard line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts. And he goes down. It's a sack. They get him back at his own 3-yard line. Credit the sack there to Harold Landry. Line of scrimmage back at their own 3 now as they come up second and long. From deep in their own territory, they look to throw. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. They'd like to avoid punting from their own end zone so they can use something here on third down. They're going to look to throw. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
Looks like a second empty possession to start the game, and certainly not the way you want to start when you're coming off of a loss last week. Every team talks about starting fast. They're hoping on their next possession it can be a delayed fast start and get them going.
A good head down running on the return gets about 15 yards. And the Titans are going to start this drive in great field position as they take over first and 10. On first down, Henry. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Back to throw. This will go to Henry out wide. Yeah, he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Ready for the second quarter from Tennessee, and it's the homestanding Titans in possession. No score after one on EA Sports. So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. It's complete to Brown, right side. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And he gets him a little bit closer. He takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
Throw to St. Brown, complete on the left side. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. They call it a loss of a yard there. And that's going to bring up an interesting third and goal. But looked like the defense, they were ready for that one.
Really left him almost no room to work after catching the ball. He could throw every move in the book at him. They were there, and they tackle him for a loss.
Now let's see where they turn on third and goal from the 5. Yeah, he is marked down right about on top of that imaginary yellow line, but they say he's a bit short. It'll be a gain of 5, but they do keep him out of the end zone, and now it's fourth down. They'll run. It's Henry. And he gets in. Touchdown, Tennessee. Derrick Henry. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Titans' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Bullet good on the extra point. And it's now a 7-0 game. Now Bullock will send this one away after the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. A pass there complete to Sutton. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Oh, Sutton, a nice catch. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35.
Boy, that completion comes with a high degree of difficulty, especially on the catch. Had to look that one in one-handed, able to do so, and ends up picking up a first down as well.
Hands it off out of the gun. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35. The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9. They'll look to throw here. And this one's incomplete. So he's 3 for 7 throwing the football right now. Not an awful start, but also not the sharpest of starts.
No, I would agree with that. But if you're a confident quarterback and to play that position, you have to be. You just act like there's something wrong with the wind currents or something wrong with the ball. It is not you. Keep throwing. That timing usually develops.
Got to get to the 26 for a first. This is 3rd down. Now back to throw. toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge, and that's good enough for a first down.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And he's going to have the hook up to Sutton. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran it a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Open man, and again it's Sutton. And the Broncos are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5. First and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. A great effort there. His 6th touchdown of the season. And the Broncos are an extra point away from tying the football game. McManus's point after is good. And we are tied here in the second quarter. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. On the return, here's a dangerous Cordarrelle Patterson. And he will make it back to the 15, and that's it. Good coverage there by the kick team. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. The pass complete to Hakeem Butler. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. A big connection on that one. 32 yards. Every defensive staff harps on limiting explosive plays. Job not so well done there.
Yeah, they talk about it all the time. A lot harder to stop, though, isn't it? And when you think of an explosive play, most offensive staffs define them as passes of 20 or more yards and runs of 15 or more yards.
They went zooming past that number there. And he is not going to go anywhere. They're going to get to him behind the line, and that is going to get us to the 2-minute warning. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
8 yards on the completion, but now they face 3rd down. To throw. He completes it to Julio Jones. And he will have a Titans first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Second and 8. Now a handoff to Henry. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Well, we know he's an electric runner. Earlier this half, you were wondering how they were going to bottle him up at different levels. That was your suggestion. Some mixed results.
Yeah, certainly, because we have seen him bottled up at times. We've seen him play him very well. We've also seen him pop the cork a few times and get out of there, haven't we?
We have indeed. They'll set up to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the 1. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's second down. It in with Henry and into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Derrick Henry, as the first half is winding down and the Titans have taken the lead. Extra point and good by Bullock, and that makes the score 14-7. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And they will not really have time to do much of anything. 15 seconds, all that remains before halftime. They go play action here on first down. Got a man open. It's Sutton. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. They'll drop to throw. And he will find his man Sutton. That's complete. And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2-yard line. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. They'll throw now on the final play. And this is caught by Sutton. Touchdown, Broncos. Cortland Sutton as time expires in the first half. And the Broncos have a chance to tie the game here in the final seconds of the half. Extra point from McManus is good. And that will take us to the end of the first half of play. So thanks to the late touchdown, it's a tie ball game here heading to break. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number 3. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
Second down and 7. Back to throw here. He completes this to Sutton. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. He's been a busy man here in this one, and they're showing off some nice footwork to stay in bounds.
And with those types of catches and the volume that we've seen in this game, wouldn't you keep him busy as well?
I would.
Of course. You got to keep throwing it to him. He keeps making plays.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Now here's a handoff out of the gun. Gets past one man. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
So operating from Tennessee territory now, here's first and 10, right at the 40. He'll look to throw. He finds his man, complete. It's Sutton. A gain of six there on first. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Second down at four. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And that's complete. Albert Okuebuna. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line.
Oh, a lot of credit to the play caller here. He saw the design in his mind and implemented it. A little zone stretcher here because they started the tight end on the left side of the formation and sent him on a crossing route. And this works really well when you can find that space between levels, and they were able to do so for good yardage.
And the stop will come inside the five at the four. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so. Now a handoff looking right. And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. A great play there. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Broncos have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half. Now McManus to tack on the extra point. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Now it's Patterson. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down seven following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
And they need to take a good, relaxing, deep breath, don't you think? Because right now they might start to feel like they've got to play catch-up here and start matching them point for point. But it's still too early to get there. They can still run their offense. Plenty of time to get back in this game.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Again, it's Henry. And this Bronco defense really selling out to stop the run, and it pays off. They get him behind the line twice in a row. Third down, now even tougher. Third and 13 after that loss of a yard. They'll look to throw. Man open, it's St. Brown, he's got it. And he will have a Titans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
Now a play fake here on first down. Rolling to his right. He's going deep for Brown. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Michael O.J. Mudia. And the Broncos are in great shape here as they take over at their 46-yard line. A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. Second and nine now. He finds his man complete. It's Sutton. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds.
And we've seen him have success earlier on with the ball in his hands because he is a get it in space and make a play kind of a receiver. But that time, they closed on him quickly and held him to a short gain.
Could be four down territory even if they don't get this, but they need just a few inches here on third. Now they try the right side here. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. Well, they gave themselves options there on the third down play and were able to convert on that RPO.
Shows a lot of trust with the guy taking the snap, doesn't it? Because you're counting on him to make the right reads and give the ball where it's supposed to go. And he did on that play.
They stay on the ground. This time it's Williams. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. Rashad Evans out of Alabama had the tackle defensively.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. That second down play nets a minus four. Got an extra defensive back out there for the Titans now here for third down. On play action, they'll throw. Escaping the pressure right. He'll let this go deep for Sutton. And this is caught inside the five. A huge play there for Denver.
There's no doubt in my mind that not many guys in this league have had the impact that he's had here in the first half of the season. He's been a big play guy from the word go and continues to be one with another one right there.
It'll be first and goal when we come back. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Now a handoff as they run left side. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there and now second down. And they'll run again. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down. From the gun, they'll try to run it. Call it no gain on the play, so no help there. And now fourth and goal.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
And McManus able to put it through. And that will push the lead up to double digits now at 10. So that's, CD, an important one here in the fourth quarter.
And that importance cannot be overstated. All eyes on both sidelines were staring that one down all the way. The significance is that they made it a 2-score game. Still lots of time left to go, but likely that was their goal at the start of the drive. Get 3 points, make it a 2-score game, and they were able to get it done.
Titans offense set to begin the drive. A tougher task for them now. That turnover on their last possession led to the field goal, meaning that they have to now try to erase a 2-score deficit here in the fourth. They go over the middle, and it's complete to start the drive. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Looking to throw. This is caught. It's Brown. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out.
Well, every drive from here out is definitely crucial and critical. They know that they need to get at least 3 here to get it back to a 1-score game. But I can't imagine that in their huddle that they're thinking at all about getting a field goal. They want to get in.
Vic Fangio's thought about it, and he'll indeed throw the red flag. And we'll get a moment here as they look this one over.
Yeah, remember now, the call on the field is what they'll stick with unless they have clear video evidence to the contrary. And I give these officials a lot of credit. Such a tough and demanding job. You and I both know that. Yeah, they make the right call way more often than they get it wrong.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And he finds his target. It's Schultz. A 9-yard pickup, just 1 yard away from 3 consecutive first down plays.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made it a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he could break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. They'll look to throw again. The left side completion to Jones. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Back to throw now on first down. He'll buy some time right. Open man, Julio. Touchdown, Tennessee. Julio Jones. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Titans have made it a 1-score game again here in the fourth. Oh, I was just about to say he hadn't missed an extra point all season, but there it is. His first miss, no good. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. KJ Hamler returning it. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have three timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit and you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it three times and punt it, you've got another thing coming.
Yeah, and by the way, also the two-minute warning in play, so essentially four timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end, and he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's up over midfield and down into Tennessee territory. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40.
But they didn't accomplish their goal. They didn't get a stop there, gave up another first down. They have all three timeouts in their pocket. I think defensively, you've got to start thinking about using them here.
I was just going to ask you, at what point you think now's the go time?
I think now's the go time. I don't think you sit back and wait, because they can take a lot of time off the clock between plays and run 3 to 4 and really put you in a stressful spot.
And now here's a carry heading left. And he can only manage to get a couple. 2nd and 8 coming up.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
The old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8. Hands it off out of the gun. Only a gain of a couple there. That leaves him needing about 7 here on 3rd down. 4th quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a 1-score game. So it's Bronco football as we get your reset here. They're facing a critical 3rd down now as they try to hold on to this lead. Back to throw. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up 4th down.
They went with the dime look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
The kick by McManus is good. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in 3. From a defensive perspective, though, I think maybe they're saying, hey, we did what we needed to do, kept this a 1-score game.
Yeah, without a doubt, because they were able to bleed some time off the clock, right? Put themselves in a good position, but it's not out of reach yet, okay? Being able to hold them to a field goal means that they do have a chance to come back and win this game.
Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. And the points, they have come fast and furious in this quarter.
you really don't want to be on the defensive side of the ball right now, do you? Because you're either thinking, my replacement may get an opportunity.
Your head better be on a swivel.
Totally. Or maybe I just need to get out of the game for a while because I just can't slow these guys down.
He's got a man complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A big play that time through the air. 34 yards. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Henry will get it. He's been busy today. A beautiful fake. And he's taken down inside the 30. 45 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot.
Okay, there's three timeouts left, right?
Think you got to use one here, don't you?
No doubt about it. I'd use one right here.
The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. He'll look to throw. He finds his man complete. It's Schultz. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. They'll look to throw. Flush to his right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Whew, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
He's back to throw. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. They took their shot for the end zone, almost cost him.
And he made the right play there, knocking it away. But boy, it looked like he had a chance to come down with the football. And if he does that, this thing is over. Instead, he leaves them out there with another chance.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Back to throw. Forced out to his left. And it's caught. It's a touchdown. So they rally here in the final minute, and they're an extra point away from tying this game. Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And we are tied in the fourth quarter. Boy, hard to ask for a better game thus far. 27 apiece is our score as the kick's away. Hamler now to return it. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20.
The Broncos take over first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range. Not much. A tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward, okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out, get to overtime, and try and win it there.
All right, we'll see if they do just that. Now the Broncos going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in the game. So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll set up a throw. They're able to get this to Patrick. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They'll set up to throw. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40.
And partner, in a tie game in the fourth quarter, you and I both know in the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars, and he came through with a nice catch right there.
To throw again. That is taken in by the tight end Fant. And now they're going to get the timeout. A huge play has him in field goal range with a chance to win. And we will get a timeout with two ticks left. So this thing rests on the shoulders of Brandon McManus. 2 seconds on the clock. This for the win. And his kick is good. He knocks through his third field goal of the game, and this one is the one that decides it. And it'll be all smiles on Blake Street tonight. The Broncos have won it. So this one will wind up a Denver victory. And they say it's never easy to come into Denver to win because of the altitude. They look pretty comfortable.
So it's not nice.